Something strange happened here. 2 decades after some ants arrived on this Kenyan savanna, lions were killing many more buffalo and far fewer zebras. But how do these seemingly disparate events relate? Well, let's rewind. Around the early 2000s, a species called big-headed ants landed in Kenya's Laikipia Plateau, probably hitching rides on imported produce. Since their suspected origins on an island in the Indian Ocean, big-headed ants have become among the world's most widespread invasive species. Their colonies can have multiple queens and reproduce year-round, expanding rapidly into extensive super-colonies sustained by voracious foraging and hunting. They prey on other insects, spiders, and even small birds. This all spells trouble for many of their new neighbors. And in Laikipia, perhaps most notably, lots of native acacia ants are nearby. Their existence is closely entwined to the area's whistling thorn acacia trees, which are clad in spiky armor. But this isn't enough to defend the trees against savanna herbivores that could eat them to death. And that's where acacia ants come in. Acacia trees are myrmecophytes, one of around 700 plant species that have evolved mutualistic relationships with ants. In Laikipia, some acacia ant species claim specific whistling thorn trees and live within them, boring holes and nesting in the bulbous hollow structures at the base of the tree's modified thorns. The acacias provide the ants shelter, nectar, and other nutritious secretions, often in return for fierce defense. When the ants sense certain vibrations, they secrete alarm pheromones from their mandibular glands and swarm out of their nests in droves, poised to sting and bite intruders, be it invading insects or the tender trunks and mouthparts of grazing herbivores. Whistling thorn acacias and their associated ants have historically dominated hundreds of thousands of square kilometers in East Africa. But researchers observed significant changes to the landscape as whistling thorn trees dropped by over 70% in some areas between 2000 and 2020. Something was going on here. These changes seemed to lead back to the introduction of those tiny, ferocious, big-headed ants. They threaten competitors, attacking in swarms, killing adult acacia ants, eating their eggs and young, and essentially decimating their populations. And without their usual militant ant resonance, acacias then become especially vulnerable to defoliation, breaking, and toppling by large herbivores like elephants. Big-headed ants also nest in the ground, tunneling near tree roots, and can cause water stress among acacia trees and limit their ability to photosynthesize and store sugars. And this is where lions, zebras, and buffalo come in. Zebras are among Laikipia lions' main prey, while water buffalo are less ideal because they pose more of a threat. To up the odds of a zebra hunt, East African lions tend to rely on the art of ambushing, covertly stalking their prey before finally pouncing. For that, they require cover. Lions in Laikipia are 3 times more likely to catch zebras in tree-heavy areas than in open grasslands, where zebras can better spot them with time to escape. But because of how big-headed ants threaten acacia trees, their presence has been shown to increase the visibility across a savanna landscape almost threefold within just 3 years. So, between 2003 and 2020, as big-headed ant activity led to more and more acacia trees collapsing, grasslands spread, and lion kills went from being 67% to 42% zebra, and 0 to 42% water buffalo. It seems lions switched to their second, more dangerous choice of prey. So, big-headed ants threatened acacia ants, leaving acacia trees defenseless against herbivores like elephants, which altered the landscape leaving less cover for lions, which made zebras tougher targets. So lions started going for water buffalo. Putting these ecological pieces together, scientists realized this also probably wouldn't be the chain reaction's end. The impact switching prey will have on local lion life remains to be seen. Plus, other animals like superb starlings and endangered black rhinos also rely on acacias. And all of it began with tiny ants sending ripples through an ecosystem long stabilized by an intricate web of relationships, its underpinnings exposed through total disruption, no matter how small the start. If you love learning, subscribe to our channel. Every week, we publish new videos on everything from the history of the world according to cats to how to be a better listener. Stay tuned and stay curious.